sure is great to get out of that bag.
The launch of the original Macintosh was held on January 24, 1984, at the Flint Center of the Performing Arts in Cupertino, California. This was mostly a two-hour shareholder meeting, Apple's State of the Union, if you will, but also the first public appearance of the Macintosh after the much-talked-about 1984 Super Bowl ad aired just 2 days earlier.
We shall prevail.
On January 24th, Apple Computer will introduce Macintosh. And you'll see why 1984 won't be like 1984.
You've just seen some pictures of Macintosh. Now I'd like to show you Macintosh in person. All of the images you are about to see on the large screen will be generated by what's in that bag.
Steve had, of course, something big planned for the finale. He wanted the Macintosh to introduce itself. But let's not get ahead of ourselves, shall we? Less than 2 years earlier, a third-party developer named Mark Barton released a software package for the Apple II, the Atari computers, and later Commodore 64 that was quite extraordinary. It was the first commercial software-based text-to-speech system, S.A.M.
Hello everyone, it sure is nice to be here today. I am S.A.M. The most versatile.
But that's not all. S.A.M. could also sing. And this was done in real time on a 1 MHz 6502 CPU and a makeshift DAC. Quite impressive. So impressive, in fact, that Apple provided Mark Barton an early Mac development system just to see what he could come up with on a machine with a 68,000 CPU and an 8-bit DAC running at 22-something kHz. Well, at least, that is Andy Hertzfeldt's version of the story. Hertzfeldt is the primary software architect for the original Mac, and also the author of the book Revolution in the Valley, an insider account of the development of the Macintosh. Hertzfeldt said he helped Mark Barton with the Mac sound driver, basically bypassing it, and when Steve heard the result, he supposedly immediately wanted that voice to be on the Mac launch. Hasmik Seropian, then Apple trainee manager, mentioned that Apple was originally interested in S.A.M. as a potential, less space-hungry substitute to digital audio files for the onboard guided tour of the Macintosh. But Steve didn't want to pay a team to port S.A.M. just for that. Of course, he changed his mind at the last minute for the launch, but by then, the production of the guide as standard audio cassettes was well underway and the Macintosh narration never happened.
This is the guided tour of Macintosh. If you've set up your Macintosh as shown in the unpacking and setup instructions, please find the disc with the title, A Guided Tour of Macintosh, and insert it into the disk drive below the screen.
Now, according to Joseph Katz, Mark Barton's new partner, who worked with him on what would eventually be renamed Macintalk, Apple contacted him and Barton in late 83 to write a speech synthesizer for their yet-to-be-released Mac. Originally, Macintalk was supposed to be included in the system folder and bundled with every Mac as part of the basic OS. Apple wanted, at the very least, a preliminary version working for the 84 introduction. The launch was near, and the demo's memory footprint was not optimized. The full demo, including screenshots, the scrolling Macintosh text, failed to run on the stock 128KB launch machines. The opening scene in Danny Boyle and Aaron Sorkin's 2015 Steve Jobs movie is actually centered on the voice demo failing just minutes before the launch.
We need it to say hello.
You're not hearing me. It's not going to say hello.
Fix it.
Fix it?
Yeah.
In 40 minutes?
Fix it.
I can't.
Who's the person who can?
I'm the person who can, and I can't.
In a recent interview, Hertzfeldt noted the liberties taken by Sorkin's script and that the voice demo did not fail just before launch, although Sorkin insists it did.
The only thing that really happened where I said it happened, when I said it happened, was they couldn't get the Mac to say hello.
In reality, the memory issue was fixed beforehand in the lab by cheating a little using one of the two prototype 512K Macs, which were not to be released for another 8 months. This setup could run both the voice and the animations.
For the first time ever, I'd like to let Macintosh speak for itself.
Hello, I'm Macintosh. It sure is great to get out of that bag. And accustomed as I am to public speaking, I'd like to share with you a maxim I thought of the first time I met an IBM mainframe. Never trust a computer you can't lift. Obviously I can talk, but right now, I'd like to sit back and listen. So it is with considerable pride that I introduce a man who's been like a father to me, Steve Jobs.
MacinTalk was the star of the day, but its voice was not heard for more than a year. Learn what happened next time.
There are more people who can tell you about the ad than can tell you who won the game.
I understand, but the ad said the Mac was gonna save the world. It didn't say it was gonna say hello.